Morning, everybody. Is everybody ready? You guys good? Okay. Good morning. I'm Chief Stump with Springsbury Township Police Department. Here with Dr. Snell to my right, Superintendent of Central York High School, and District Attorney of York County, Dave Sunday, to my left. Again, we're here just to keep you updated on our investigation to the threats that were made to Central York High School the other day. We do not have anyone in custody at this time. We are continuing to receive tips. They've been coming in all through the night. We continue to receive them this morning, and we are investigating each and every one of them thoroughly. We still have the full task force up and running. Again, approximately 20 plus investigators from local, state, and federal agencies, and we are relentlessly pursuing these threats. We are continuing to ask the community to send us any tips that you may have. Our preferred way of receiving those tips are at stpdtips@springinsbury.com. We'll take some questions.
Chief, could you perhaps give us an indication of, and this may not be the case, but is there a growing level of frustration over the inability to practice this?
Amongst who?
I'm sorry?
Your question, amongst who?
Are you folks frustrated with the fact that you haven't been able to find the person?
Yeah, our desire would have been to solve this days ago. And, you know, we have probably a few hundred man hours over the last few days involved in this investigation. It is difficult. It's a timely process. We want to make sure we're following the laws and doing everything the appropriate way. We don't want to leave a single stone unturned. So yeah, it's a lot of legwork. We're getting down to detectives doing old-fashioned police work, going person to person, door to door, and doing everything we have to do. So is it wearing? Yes, but I would say it's wearing on the whole community the same as it is us.
What do you account for some of the difficulties with arresting suspects?
It's hard to explain that one without going into the investigation. I just don't want to go into that at this time. We do.
How many?
We continue to get persons of interest. We've been able to eliminate some, and we still have more that we're interested in.
Chief, yesterday you talked about, I believe you said something about don't protect whoever it might be that may have made these threats. Is that, can you kind of elaborate on that just a little bit, as much as you can?
Yeah, and asking for the community's support. Our goal is to protect the 5,800 students that attend school in our district every single day. One student or one person, and I don't want to assume this is a student, it could be an adult. One person is bringing us to a halt in our day-to-day activities, our education. So why are we protecting someone who's threatening the lives of our kids in our community? I don't understand that. If someone knows something, they need to get it out.
Do you feel that is happening, that there is some level of protection that's going on?
We have concerns that it possibly is happening. We feel that somebody out there knows something that's not being shared at this time.
Chief, do you believe this is a sole individual or more than one?
We are open to both at this time. We haven't narrowed that down. We're keeping all investigative routes open to single or multiple.
How long do you expect schools to
close? I'm sorry, I couldn't hear.
How long do you expect schools to close?
We're going day by day with that. You know, eventually, we do have to consider how that's going to look going back. If we don't have someone in custody, when we do get someone in custody, it's something that, you know, we're going to have to start discussions on. We can't allow this to shut us down long term. That's really a decision Dr. Snell's going to make. However, it will be with guidance from us based on where we feel the investigation is as well.
How frustrating is this? I mean, have you ever had a case like this before where you feel so determined to solve it and
yeah, we have had very good success in threats in the past. This one's definitely been a longer process than any we've ever had. I feel like we have the right team together working on it. We got some of the best investigators in this county and state and government I think there is around. So I feel good about the investigative process, but yeah, we'd like to have someone, we'd like to bring this to a closure.
Obviously, safety is paramount, but do you know if the school year is going to have to go into the summer with closing schools for multiple days now?
I don't know. Would you like to?
At this time, with any cancellation, the practice is to put it on to the end of the school year. There are no more makeup days. And so that's our answer at this point. We will continue to put the days on to the end of the school year. Are there other remedies in place? There are, and those conversations can be had at a later time.
Dr. Snell, a follow-up question. Any thoughts about confusion?
Our first goal is to get things back to normal as soon as possible. And to the statement earlier, there are kids at home that aren't being educated. That's our first goal, is to get everybody back to normal. Regardless of what school shooting has transpired, we've always had conversations about what is next. How do we continue to increase safety and security in all of our schools across the county? All of us, all the superintendents have those conversations. But in Central York, we are having those conversations. We will announce later today at town meeting that we will bring our community together with other local agencies to have that very conversation about what is the right fix going forward after this tragedy of last week.
Do you have metal detectors in any of your buildings?
No, sir.
Do you have any police officers patrolling your building?
We have one school resource officer.
In just one school building?
That shares through several of our schools. So as far as the metal detectors, we do not have any metal detectors. Are there wands? We have some metal detector wands in our district.
Would it be a good idea to install metal detectors in your buildings?
I think that's a conversation the community has to have going forward. I wouldn't make that decision without the support of the board, without the support of the community, and I think that's our next step with the town meeting.
What message would you have for parents and students who are maybe getting frustrated at this point?
We shared with our community and our parents yesterday some talking points, a couple of resources on what to do. So for parents out there, I would suggest that they continue to have really good conversations with their children. And that's one conversation at a time, eyeball to eyeball, face to face. That's important. To our students, I would say, return that respect to your parents and continue to have really good conversations about what this means in this day and age with going to school, with going to any public place. And to our community, I would say to continue to speak up. If you see something, say something. But all of this has to happen one conversation at a time. It does no good to fuel frustration via social media. We are all working hard, and I appreciate the gentleman here and all the support that we have as this district. But we need to have really good conversations around dinner tables in this community and around the community coming together to talk about a way forward, just not one individual making any single recommendation.
But you still can't expect us to send our children to school if this person does not count, correct? Like, if this person's not found in school in session, you can't expect our children to come to school if they don't want to.
As I said last night, at some point, well, let me just reiterate. At some point, we have to cross that conversation of when do we come back, whether we have somebody in custody or not. As I said last night, any parent has the right to keep their child home if they feel that that situation is unsafe.
And if the children do return to school after this person is found, will there be counselors set up if our children want to go and talk to them?
Absolutely. So let me just say that on behalf of the district, we have a number of protocols and structures in place regarding security, visitor management software, the same things that all the schools work very, very hard at. On the other side of the equation, I'm very proud of the district and the support of the board and the efforts to around the mental health component. We have counselors. We work with TW Panessa. We've created alternative classrooms to help kids that struggle with any academic issues, be them solely academic or mental health. And so there are a number of structures in place. We have EAP programs for the adults in the building who, let me just say, are saints teachers, support staff, bus drivers, all of them that come to school every day and protect children. They are saints. We have EAP programs for them. So there are a number of supports and structures there for everybody. Ultimately, we need to start the conversation of when are we going to come back to school, but those supports are in place.
All right, folks, that's it.
Just one last thing. We'll be back at 5 p.m. right here to have bring you up to speed with where we're at.